How many of us want to worship God the way Solomon worshipped? And many of us want to worship God the way David worshipped? How many of us want to worship God the way Noah worshipped? I remember the day after the flood, Noah came out of the ark and he selected some choice animals as he offered sacrifices to God and worshipped. God perceived the sweet smell, the sweet aroma of the praises of his heart and the aroma of the burnt offering. And God said, as from today, I will never use flood, I will never use water to destroy man again. We worship you, Holy Father. A time is coming when we shall come before your throne in heaven, when there shall be no hustling and bustling here and there, when there shall be no Boko Haram, when there shall be no sickness, when barrenness and death shall be in prison forever. And all we shall do is to sing hallelujah, glory, honor, majesty to your holy name. Even right here on earth, we want to worship. Worship that pleases you. Enlighten the eyes of our hearts. Father, we need your presence. Come down with your cloud of understanding. Take over the whole of this cathedral. Take over everywhere as far as my voice can go. Take over. Let the atmosphere be charged with your spirit. Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Give a clap of praise to Jesus as we sing. I want to congratulate every one of us that are seated here today. It is a privilege. Sometimes when I look at the work, how tedious the work of God is, I will say, God, when will somebody round up this contract with you? The thing is tedious. It's not easy. And then another thought will come into my mind. But do you know it's a privilege to be useful to your God? So I want to congratulate every one of us. Congratulations. For having this rare privilege to worship the God of God, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the only true God, the only living God. Congratulations. Some worship idols and they worship rejoicing. Some worship demons. Some worship even on arrow sticks. They just go to the bush, cut them, carve them after one likeness or the other, and they worship. They kill goats and offer sacrifices. But we ourselves, we have the living true God. If you want to clap for God, you can clap. It is a privilege to worship, even if you are born into a Christian home. I still want to congratulate you because we have people today who were born into a Christian family. Even some, their parents were pastors. But at the end, they turned herbalists. They became herbalists. But you are here. You have this rare privilege to sing and dance for the Lord. All God wants to tell us today is that we should make good use of this privilege so that our dancing, our giving, our serving, any form of worship we render to Him will not be useless, but will become holy and acceptable to God. Shout hallelujah. Psalm 69, 30 and 31. Psalm 69. I will praise the name of God with a song, and I will magnify Him with thanksgiving. I will praise the name of God with a song, and I will magnify Him with thanksgiving. 31. This also shall please the Lord better than an ox or bullock that hath horns and hoofs. Praise the Lord. I have met one or two persons who refuse to sing and worship God with their voice. And their sole complaint is that I don't know how to sing. We were told a story that a madman came from the bush and he was singing this song. Imire ni rewo abiji lo lori na mafowa na rabo mabero mojo imire ni rewo abiji lo lori na o mafowa na rabo mabero mojo. Where the madman entered the forest, he saw trees praising God. He visited ponds, he saw fishes worshiping God, praising God. He could see the trees bowing, prostrating before God. And the wind helping them to bow very well. In a rhythmic manner, they were bowing and worshiping God. And the madman said, sure, even trees worship God too. Even animals, they worship too. How about you? How about me? Remember, we are created for the glory and the praise of God. And the psalmist says, God inhabits the presence of His people. If we can learn how to worship God in an acceptable form, I tell you, some of the prayers we pray, we will not pray them. Our sister that gave a testimony said, or Fano said in one of the songs, that if you have prayed and prayed and prayed, and nothing is working out, you need to pray, and you will see God working wonders for you. May God use praise as a weapon of war in our lives in Jesus' name. What is worship? Worship is the honor with extravagant love and extreme submission. Extravagant love and extreme submission. When you have so much love, the love that is immeasurable. It is love that moves us to worship. We may not define why we worship God correctly. It's a mystery. When you think, one of our mommies said, as I woke up, as I was passing along the road, I was just worshiping God. I was just singing. One of the things that baffles we Christians is that when you worship God, we can't understand ourselves again. And then, a mystery about the glory of God is unfolded. As it unfolds, you flow in the spirit realm, and the next thing is that you see yourself carried away. You get lost. You forget where you are. And the next minute is that you see joy flowing down, running through your cheek, from your eyes, running down. I said, God, who am I to worship you? Who has ever cried before? Who has ever cried during praise, worship? You are worshiping God and you started crying. Why did you shed tears? It is because the Spirit of the Lord flowed into your spirit. The Bible says God inhabits the presence of His people. As you worship God, God comes down Himself. Remember what the Lord said? He said, I will never share my glory with any man. So when it is time to worship God, see, if it is time for prayer, God can send an angel to come and collect the prayer. Daniel was praying, Who came? Which angel came? Angel Gabriel came to collect the prayer. And then the prince of Persia showed up. But when it comes to praise, when it is about praise, God comes down himself. Because he doesn't want anything to touch his praise. God is so jealous when it comes to worship. He is so jealous, And he proclaimed, he said, I, the Lord your God, I am what? A jealous God. I am so jealous about my worship. You don't give it to any man. Do we have jealous men in the house? Do we have jealous women in the house? It's natural. Clap for yourself. It's normal. It's normal. Do you expect me to watch one hooligan to hug my wife, touch her? Will you try it? Men, can you try it? Even if you just quarrel with the wife now, then you will see another man inside that man roaring. Hey, what are you doing? Stop it, my wife. And women, I trust you. See, you are created in the image of God and after God's own likeness. So if God is jealous about you, that trait, that characteristic is in you. So whatever thing you share so much, I said, this one, now my heart, now my love. There are some things that belong to you only. And those things, no go in here. Praise the Lord. God is so jealous about worship. If you give God quality worship, God will come down himself and say, yes, this is what I want. See, God has emotions. Do you have emotions? Do you have feelings? God can be angered. Eh? God can be pleased. God can be pleasure. And I remember that day, after the flood, there was no activity on earth because there was water everywhere. No activity. Humans were restrained in a small ark. But when man came out and saw the earth again, he said, the earth looks beautiful. What's the next thing I need to do now? What's the next thing? Okay, he selected clean animals, prepared a very nice altar, and worshipped God. How many of us have seen the rainbow before? It is because somebody gave God quality worship. And God stretched his finger and said, over the sky, I hereby draw my finger. As from today, I will never do this again. Some of the floods we experience is because of our negligence. Worry, don't we experience floods? Eh? The small canal we have, do we maintain them? Even some of us, we blame government. You carry your debt, those beans, and you pour them. Go to main market, you see women in action. That one, eh? In a Zogbeja market, that small river there, they have filled it, it's like a gutter. So when you see flood coming, don't blame God. Don't ask God. God, you said in Genesis that you will not use water to destroy the world again. This one is man-made. When we gather water together because we want to generate electricity, and we neglect the dam, if it breaks, people will die. Then God from heaven will say, look at my rainbow. I am still keeping to my word. When we worship God, he will do extraordinary things. There was another time the children of Israel went to war. As they were fighting, they said, the battle is too fierce. What do we do? Then they said, the man of God is here. The man of God said, is anybody with an instrument? Come and play. They brought a harp. And as they were playing, the Spirit of God, tell this man of God off, and the word of prophecy came. and there was victory. There was water everywhere for them to drink. Some of us, our life, we lack grease. You know grease? Lubricant. We lack lubricant. Because it is, Lord, give me no worship. Worship means you are saying you want worship. You are qualified. So whenever we say, Lord, I worship you, you are saying, Lord, you are worthy. John chapter 4, verse 23 and 25. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is what? God is spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. There are three major things about worship as far as it concerns the spirit. You worship God in spirit. You worship and fellowship with the spirit. And you also worship by the spirit. Worship is about spirit. It's a spiritual phenomenon. So when you worship God in the spirit, God comes down and solves all the problems. Means, it is better for me to invite God than to send my prayers to God. It is better for me to invite God into my situation than for me to send my prayers to God in heaven. When you send your prayers to God in heaven, God will answer and send your request. He will send your desire. But if you can succeed to pull God from heaven, hey, every challenge in that environment will disappear. I pray for somebody in the house. If you are a worshiper in this house, may people see the fruits of worship in your life. I say, evidences of worshiper of God. Let those evidences be seen in your life. God is looking for true worshippers who will worship God in spirit and in truth. Where do we worship God? Where? We worship God everywhere. Where did Paul and Silas worship God that day? Where? In the prison. Did God show up? God appeared in the prison. And the Bible says, as they were worshiping, the chains of everybody became loose. Everybody in the prison became free. So when you succeed in bringing down God, there was another day, Solomon worshipped God. And he worshipped and slaughtered animals. As he slaughtered animals, anyhow. So the end said that the altar was too small for the sacrifice. And then God said, What will I do? What am I going to do for Solomon? Solomon, what can I do for you? Solomon said, God, you know I'm a little child. What do I need? Lord, give me wisdom. I said, is it only wisdom you asked for? You didn't ask me to kill all your enemies. You didn't ask me for money. Now, every other thing that you need in your life, both faith, security, where everything I give to you, take it, boom. And Solomon became the richest man. So the end said that other kings and queens will travel for hours and days and months just to see and learn from Solomon. Give a clap of praise to Jesus. With what do we worship God? We worship God with our time. Time is precious. And some people, when they come to church, they look at their wristwatch. Say, what is this man of God doing? Today, church, now, wow. Because their time, they don't spend it anyhow. So then, to their own understanding, spending their time for God is spending their time anyhow. The time you spend in the house of God, can troubles meet you in that place? Then we can worship God with our material. With our material. You worship God with what you have. When some people are asked to give to God, drama. Then you see people, no, they will arrange the denomination from house. They know where there is 5 naira. They know where 10 naira is. I'm not saying you cannot give God 5 naira. If that is what you have, give to Him. It is your widow's mite. But when you have, and you want to give God the money that has kwashoko, then God will just wag his head and say, hey, Sisi Maria, you don't know the problem when I say, this truck when I carry, come give you this night. I wish I allow and reach you, you for vomit 1 million naira for India. Now me, you they give 5 naira. And God himself will be praying forgiveness prayer for you. May God open our eyes one day. One day. Not this physical eyes, though. Spiritual eyes. And allow us, permit us to see all the demons that will be flying past our roof, all the witches and all the wizards, everything, the troubles, all the arrows they are shooting in the night. May God open our eyes one day. If you believe, say amen. Now, who gets that accident in Hosanna? Now, it's a bit thank God. Who travels? No accident. You know, they thank God. He say, how was the journey? He say, it was very smooth. We bless God. That is all. But if 4 tires loose for road, you call the holler, Jesus, God of divine encounter. The next minister, now, Vika, what did God do today? Let me thank God. So when your tires no loose, God don't do anything. Who they shoot, he knows that. With person when not see anybody shoot them, who God do pass for? You when not see anybody shoot you. We must learn to worship God. Then we must worship God with our spirit. With our spirit, we must worship God. We worship God in spirit, by the Spirit, and with the Spirit. The Spirit of God directs our worship. That is why if the Spirit of God is not in the music, it's not in the song, it will look dry. But if the Spirit of God is in it, whether the voice is cracking or you will be carried into heaven immediately. And when you worship God by the Spirit, your spirit will push you to pick the right song and to ask the way God wants you to ask. There are churches today where they don't have children working for God. How many of us work in divine encounter here? How many of us work, render services to God? How many of us? Just raise up your hand. Just if you work here, if you work, maybe you arrange chairs, you do one work. Divine encounter, you do one work or the other. Can you clap for God so that God will bless these people? Just clap for them. Do you know that as early as 5 o'clock, people will come around, especially the church in Jacob Ukeri, we start arranging these canopies. A word of prophecy came one day to a girl, and God said, find something to do in the house of God. That is your deliverance. Some of us, our activities, these are our activities. We come from the house, hurriedly, we get to the gate, collect the program, Come inside. There is a seat you have bought with your money, but you didn't pay to us. Maybe you paid in Abuja. If anybody sits there, you use any means. This is Mama, you must get up. And then, after that chaos, you worship God. The next minute, some will even bring their offering after blessing it. In the midst of the crowd, why men sleep in business, busy, moving here and there, the money will slip inside the pocket, and then off we go. But there are others, some people will say, I've been coming to the very cathedral. God has not done anything for me. What have you done? What have you done for God? I bless God for those who support the work of God. See, there are things you give to God there. There are men of God here. There are some gifts you receive. You are provoked from your spirit. It's like the gift is placating your heart. It will tear your heart open and say, release blessings. Just pour, and from your spirit, you just release blah. At that moment, if another person comes, it will look as if none is left. You remember what Jacob told, Isaac told Jacob. He said, Esau. He said, that is ever blessing. He said, I finished everything because the food was so sweet. I finished it. I gave all the blessings. And none is left. Unless you go and download again. May God help us in Jesus' name. You remember Jesus? What I'm saying in scripture, Jesus said, virtue left me. That is power just left me. And when he has done some miracles, he will go to the mountain and pray and reveal himself. Some of us, we cannot release our children to work for God. And those children, when they are in school, they can spend their precious time in the club. Meanwhile, you cannot allow them to spend 3 hours in the house of God. But there, they can read in the club, read book, in the club. When you call them, they will try to tell you, mommy, I was reading so bad that I had to put my phone on silent, sorry. Meanwhile, they were in the club. If they answer you, you will hear the sound of their willow there. And you will be tempted to ask, where are you, Justin? So they will not pick the call that time. Whatever thing we do, if we do it with the whole of our heart, there are blessings. And as many that have been faithful in their worship, may the Lord release his blessings today. I say, may the Lord release his blessings today. What about dancing? Dancing. Does God accept our worship through dancing? Does he accept? I said, does he accept? How many of us have our style here? Our style of dance. How many of us? How many of us get style? How many of us get step for your step? You get step for Jesus? Do you have your own step? Shout hallelujah. The man that will put his hand into his pocket and will never shake his body for God, that man is imitating somebody. That man is imitating somebody in the mortuary. If you are alive, take your body for Jesus. If you are alive, whether you know how to dance or not, see, even the deaf, they sing. You don't hear God talk what they say, and this deaf man, this deaf woman, he despoils the song. You don't hear God want it. The deaf, they sing. They sing. And God accepts the worship because it is a thing of the heart and of the spirit. But there are some worship that God does not accept. Whether they sing, and somebody is doing like this. For God? Is that for God? There are things that God will never take from us. Some things are nonsense. I have been to a place and I requested for water. They gave me very clean water. But when I looked at the cup, I said, I'm not thirsty again. The cup, oil stain, different kind of colors. I said, I respect your water, but I have no respect for the vessel. The vessel of worship is very, very important to God. In Genesis chapter 4, the Bible says, unto Cain first, and to his offering, God has no respect. So God will look at the worshiper first. After scanning through the life of the worshiper, he will not look at what you are bringing. Whether it be worship, whether it be dance, whether it be offering, anything you want to use to worship God, God will not look at it. If he gives you a pass mark, then heaven is open for you. Some of us will be like where sea water and river water they meet. A sterile water, where the salt water and the fresh water is mixing together. If you talk about reggae, you not fit win me. If it comes to church, you not fit beat me at all. So you yourself, you have salt water, you have fresh water. And because you are used to check your bubble outside. When the musician is singing and he says, check your body, all your understanding is check your bubble. Because that is what you are used to. If they say, check it, then you position yourself. Those who dance as Zoto in the town, when they come here, we recognize them. Those who dance Makosa in those days, are willow, till today, you can't remove the step from your leg. You cannot remove, you will always see, somebody said your character will always find you out. You cannot hide character. Go and dance this song, learn that dance step somewhere, and come and fine tune it, we will still know. May the Lord help us today. Worship when people they dance, kiri mama, and breast go feet fall. You go package your back. Can God accept that word? It is over there. Yeah, in a club, not everybody dance. Some will be watching and which babe. Now there your breast go feet fall and you go sell market. Not before yet. If you see the commandment of God to the priest, he said, when you come before my house, before my altar, he said, cover your nakedness. I must not see that, you know, in my house. You must tie it very well. Cover it. I must not see it. But today, do you see in church? Do you see in church? And when it's time for music, see, there is peace. When there is no song, there is no music, there is peace. The atmosphere is calm. But when there is some kind of music, there are some kind of music, and you see all the jagolofa and all the samasotin, temptation will be flying. The atmosphere of worship is the atmosphere of holiness and righteousness. The atmosphere of worship is the atmosphere where the Spirit of God moves. It's not the atmosphere, even when they say close your eyes, wave your hands to God, and somebody is tempted to open one eye and be looking anyhow because something is so attractive and tempting. Let's rise up. No ride on. No thanks. There is a place we are going to, and in that place, there is no night. We will only worship God. You see this mama, now, mama, can you jump again? Can you twist up the body the way peers do? Mama, see struggle. A time will come, even the old will leap like a young child. With handkerchiefs, people will worship God and praise and worship and say, today, they don't break, and fish they rot, may we all go market. All those worries will be no more. How many of us want to be there? We'll pray two prayer points. Lift up your two hands. The first one is, God, teach me how to worship. Worship is from God. Worship is for God and it is from God. It is for Him. It is from Him. It came from Him and we will give it back to Him. Lift up your two hands and tell the Lord, Lord, teach me how to worship. Teach me how to worship. Teach me today, now, and forever how to worship you. I want to worship. Teach me how to. The Father is looking for worshipers. True worshipers who will worship Him in spirit and in truth. Not anyhow. There is a manual of worship. Second prayer. Second prayer point. This prayer point, we are going to use it to address our body part. The body is not for fornication, it's not for our soul, it's not for our sin, it's not for our will. It is for the Lord. You are going to talk to your own body. If it is your hand, then kiss my hand. I will only use it to worship. I will use it to worship God. I will never use it my hand. Anyhow, my leg, you must worship God. While you are alive, my heart, you must worship the Lord. The whole of my body, I will dedicate to you again. Romans chapter 12 says, brethren, I beseech you that you present your body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto the Lord. Tell the Lord to take over your body. Take over our bodies, O Lord. Just what said as for me and my heart, we would serve the Lord. Before I pray, let's take this off. Oh, Father, we come into thy presence, and from afar we will bow in awe and worship. Teach us who you are. If we know who you are and tell me who you are, we will worship you correctly. We will not worship you like idols. In our dreams, help us to partake in heavenly worship. Give us a chance of the worship of the true and living God in heaven, so that we can say, today represent God, that's a tampering with the presence of God, please open in the name of Jesus. Nothing will take your place in our life. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.